Belarus is marking Fatherland Defenders and Armed Forces Day. Traditionally, on that day, former peacekeeping soldiers or veterans-internationalists come together to look back at the past and honor the memory of their comrades in arms. They also meet with students to tell them about the role of our country in the restoration of peace on Earth. Today, the Union of Veterans-Internationalists comprises more than 1,500 Belarusians who took part in military conflicts outside of their motherland. Nowadays, the Belarusian veterans do not lose contact with their fellow soldiers from abroad, meeting with them in the territory of now peaceful countries. Belarusian and Chinese experts will meet for an international conference in Minsk on February 24th to discuss the possibilities for Belarus in the One Belt, One Road project. The forum will aim at strengthening Belarusian-Chinese cooperation, developing the scientific bases in the area of politics, economy, culture and bilateral public relations. Initiated by China, the One Belt, One Road project includes Eurasian countries, connecting developed and developing states. Tourists in Belarus can now choose among about 175 day tours. Travel agencies can offer farm tourism, culinary tours, and excursions to industrial areas. The interest in Belarus has increased considerably with the launch of the visa-free travel. We reported earlier that citizens of 80 countries can stay in Belarus for 5 days without visas as of the 12th of February. Over 1,500 foreigners have already visited our country. According to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the visa-free period may be extended to 14 days. We'll be right back.